I live in a small town in South Australia. The population around here is about 5,000. This was an old copper mining town, so it's been around for 150 years. It's true, you haven't travelled until you've been to Moonta.
You may not have heard of Moonta or longtime resident Lindsay Jackson, but for the last 3 years, this mum of two has offered a safety net for hundreds around Australia.
I was on maternity leave with my second child. I found myself unemployed because the company I was working for had closed, living in regional South Australia in a really small town, and was really, really bored. Hey, how you going? What's the response been on the putting debts on hold situation for tax time?
The debt that Lindsay is talking about is so-called Robodebt, the government's automatic system to reclaim overpaid welfare. While Lindsay was on maternity leave, thousands of Australians were receiving debt notices, some of whom hadn't been on welfare for years.
There were people that were at risk of homelessness or making the choice between paying this debt and buying food. People that had really kind of worked for the last 5 years and thought that they were at that threshold where they could buy a car or something positive was happening, and then all of a sudden they were hit with the thousands of dollars debt from the government. Do a stunt at the end.
Lindsay put her 10 years of web development experience to good use. She came up with the idea for Not My Debt, a website that was designed to be a lifeline for those distressed by sudden debt notices. She built the site and then asked for volunteers.
So quite a lot of us were mums. Lots of quite a few people had taken time out of the workforce to do some sort of caring role. They were really skilled in really interesting areas and kind of bored.
Suddenly, the website blew up with hundreds of people submitting stories asking for help.
I couldn't think straight. I couldn't sleep.
I have made so many complaints about this, and I'm seriously considering ending my own life. Not just because of the debt, but how Centrelink have handled this.
I'm utterly broken. Two disabled kids whose therapy I already can't afford.
It's always been deeply upsetting. And you know, like as a group, we know that there's a limitation to what it is that we can do, but at least providing a way for people to be able to talk about it and be heard and then hear what other people are going through. We know that that provides comfort for people.
It was very stressful, and I found, you know, thoughts going through your head, well, how am I going to cope? You know, how am I going to pay the rent.
Just before he retired, Robert was working casual shifts in aged care.
Well, I did enjoy the work immensely. I enjoyed meeting the clients that I was appointed to, and they were lovely people.
But he wasn't earning quite enough to get by, so Robert topped up his income with New Start, telling Centrelink how much he earned each fortnight. It was only after Robert retired that he got a debt notice for around $3,000.
Well, it was a shock. I received this letter from Centrelink, and they said you owed so much money to us, and they didn't go into a lot of information about where the money was or why it was owed.
Like lots of people on welfare, Robert's income fluctuated, but Centrelink's computer program averaged out his annual income information from the Australian Tax Office and compared that with what he reported fortnightly. And the data, it didn't match. So like thousands of others, Robert was automatically issued with a debt notice. To prove the debt wasn't correct, he spent months pulling together old pay slips and bank statements.
So I was basically having to prove my innocence, as they deemed that, you know, I had basically stolen this money off them. And that was what really hurt me, was that they accused me of being a thief. And it really did make me feel very depressed at the time.
Nearly half a million people have received robo-debts.
It makes you feel a second-class citizen. I heard stories of people committing suicide that, you know, that had failed to be able to see their way through it.
The government's own figures show that more than 2,000 people have died after receiving robo-debt. The program has clawed back $500 million from current and former welfare recipients, but it's come at a cost of $400 million to manage.
We've seen debts that are a few hundred dollars through to debts that are tens of thousands of dollars. And we've seen debts where the person in truth owed nothing to Centrelink, which are in thousands of dollars.
Joel Townsend is from Victoria Legal Aid, and he argues that the robo-debt system is not only unfair, it's unlawful.
So in February, we issued proceedings on behalf of Madeleine Masterton. She's a nurse who was studying and doing some work. She received a notification from Centrelink that she had a debt, and we said to her, we think that's unlawfully raised against you.
But the government wiped Madeleine's debt before they went to court and have since admitted that they got the debt wrong. Victoria Legal Aid now have a second test case, arguing that under the current system, people are guilty until they prove themselves innocent. People like 28-year-old Letitia Luti.
I remember feeling like I needed to accept that this was the debt I owed.
When she got a debt notice for more than $2,000 relating to youth allowance she received in 2011, Letitia decided to fight it. She asked for an authorised review officer to look at her case and recalculate it.
If somebody seeks a review by an authorised review officer, the legislation requires that Centrelink step through that process.
Documents seen by The Feed, released under Freedom of Information, show that Centrelink did in fact receive her request. Months later, there was no word if they had begun the official review process. Instead, they reduced Letitia's debt to $400.
It's dropped almost $2,000. Like, I feel relieved that I don't have to pay off that amount, but I also feel quite shocked and feel for a lot of people out there that may have paid debts that they didn't even owe.
One-fifth of the debt notices issued by Centrelink have since been reduced or waived.
There's a real difficulty in getting to the bottom of how many debts have been waived and in what circumstances.
After collecting years of old pay slips, Robert had his debt more than halved.
I didn't feel that I could dispute it, you know, that was set in concrete. I didn't feel that I had any rights there.
So he's agreed to pay off $15 a fortnight, and when you're on the pension, like Robert is, every little bit counts.
For me, it is money that I can ill afford to be without in my situation, and I still feel that it's wrong. And the way they have gone about it with the robo-debt setup is, in my eyes, quite fraudulent.
Even if you've paid, if you think you wrongly had a debt raised against you, seek a review, you might find that the debt was wrong and you can get your money back.
It's now been 3 years since Lindsay found herself bored and on maternity leave in Moonta, and she's never been busier.
All right, you can run, let your energy out.
Every day, volunteers are working to help those with debts they believe they don't owe.
We're just a bunch of mums and people from regional areas that just thought that this was really terrible, and it's been an incredibly rewarding community project that really has helped thousands of people and stopped people from paying money that they didn't owe.
Hey there, my name is Mark Fennell, and if you enjoyed that, and I'm hoping that you did, then make sure you like and subscribe to The Feed's YouTube channel and definitely watch that thing that I have absolutely seen before. It's really good.